Now, before I go into the different branches of occult societies like Freemasonry, Rosicrucianism, and so on and so on, I want to talk a little bit about secret societies in general. There is a difference, a very important difference between a secret society and a discreet society. A discreet society keeps discretion about what's happening on the inside, about the members, and so on. But you know that the organization is there. You just don't know what's happening inside of that organization. And a member of such an organization will not tell you the names or the identities of other members. That's discretion. A secret society is secret. That means you don't know that such a society exists. That's why they call it a secret society. And now you see the big difference between Freemasonry on the one hand, and Rosicrucianism and all these other organizations. They are not secret societies, they are discreet societies because they keep discretion. And I hope I'll learn how to pronounce that word someday. But and on the other hand, secret societies. For some time, the P2 Lodge, the famous P2 Lodge in Italy, was a secret society, because even the United Grand Lodge in London and other Freemasonic bodies didn't know what this lodge was doing for real. And as soon as the United Grand Lodge in London discovered what they were doing, they kicked them out. The problem for sure was that they didn't inform the authorities in Italy at the same time. And after the P2 Lodge got kicked out, before that you can say it was a discreet society, but after they got kicked out of Masonry, they became a secret society. Because officially it didn't exist anymore. So it was secret. Another example for a discrete society would be Skull and Bones. We know that Skull and Bones exists, but we don't know what happens inside. Skull and Bones is a discrete society, not a secret society. But people that use the word secret society rarely care for this difference. They just want to make accusations. They just want to point fingers at others. And, well, that's their own problem. That's a testament to their own weakness and personality. They are making a problem for others out of that as soon as they point their fingers. But they don't care. That most of the time they enjoy it when they cause trouble for others. And that shows that people that spill such stories are rarely highly developed on a moral in moral standards, or rather ethical standards. There's a big difference between moral and ethics. But I think that it's better to explain this difference in a different place. What more to say about this difference between secret societies and discreet societies? Well, most of the time, the real secret societies are very small, very limited in the number of their members, because it's damn hard to keep a secret. The more people are inside of the secret organization, the more people know about it. And that's a little, sounds a little paradox, but that also limits the things such a secret society can do, because when too many people know that this organization exists, even if they are threatened to keep silent, it's always a risk for that, for the secret of that organization. So most secret societies exist for a very short time, until the secret gets spilled from someone. And since they don't have that many members, they are very ineffective in performing big things, big conspiracies. On the other hand, conspiracies are something very, very normal. They happen every day, and I'm sure that everyone who's watching this video has taken part in a conspiracy in his life. And if it's just a conspiracy to pull a prank on someone. And when you look back to when you performed that prank, and the planning, and the keeping the secret and all that stuff, you might know how hard it is to keep a secret on the one hand, and on the other hand, you might know that it's absolutely normal for human beings to do such things, to conspire. Of course, it's not good. We all know that. That's why we keep our mouths shut when we conspire. But, well, it's a part of our nature. And I think that's enough for this episode. Enjoy yourself, enjoy your day, enjoy time, and enjoy life. See you soon.